So in this class we are going to learn about the function of a carburetor, how a carburetor is helping the petrol or the fuel to enter the cylinder head through the inlet valve. So draw the figure of the carburetor. This is carburetor. It has various parts. It has float chamber. A float is there which floats in the float chamber. This is similar to, this carburetor is similar to flush being used in toilets. Float chamber, float, it has parts, lever, jet. This is the air passage. Air is entering separately, fuel is entering separately into the engine. Here in this area, air and fuel mixture are mixed. This is the fuel jet, your explosive mixture, choke tube, throttle valve. These are the various parts of the carburetor. So this carburetor is a device for atomizing and vaporizing the fuel. 332. Now carburetor, this is carburetor. Draw the figure. So in the final exam it will be asked to explain the it need sketch how a carburetor functions. The carburetor is a device for atomizing and vaporizing. Carburetor is a device for atomizing and vaporizing the fuel, and it mixes fuel with the air in varying proportions to suit the changing operating conditions of the engine. So if the fuel quantity is more, air quantity is less, it is called rich mixture. If the fuel quantity is less and air quantity is more, it is called weak mixture. If air and fuel mixture is in correct proportion to start the engine, it is called stoichiometric mixture or optimizer mixture, rich mixture and weak mixture. So the carburetor is a device used for atomizing and vaporizing the fuel. The fuel is converted into small atoms, particles, and it is vaporized. Initially it is a liquid state, it is changed to vapor state by the carburetor, and carburetor is used to mix the fuel with the air. The process of breaking up and mixing the fuel with the air is called carburation. It is called carburation. The process of mixing the fuel with the air by breaking it up into small atoms is called carburation. There are different types of carburetors available, but only a simple carburetor is shown here. A simple form of carburetor is shown here. It consists of a fuel jet. This is, so you see the pointer. This is fuel jet. It consists of a fuel jet located in the center of the choke tube. This is choke tube, choke. So in winter, sometimes the engine is not started. So in that case, you are switching on the choke enter kada. So when the choke is switched on, then rich mixture, more quantity of fuel is introduced into the choke chamber, choke tube. Okay, it consists of a fuel jet. This is a fuel jet located in the center of the choke tube. A float chamber, this is a float chamber, a rectangular float chamber is there here. A float chamber is provided for maintaining the level of the fuel in the jet. To maintain the level of the fuel in the jet, a float chamber is provided and is controlled by a float. And it is controlled by a float, rectangular float. It is controlled by a float and a lever, which operates the needle valve. This is the needle valve. So you see the needle valve is there. So when the float is floating in the float chamber, needle valve is closed. When the fuel is sucked into the cylinder, the residual moves up, and again the petrol comes from the tank, fuel tank, from the petrol tank to the carburetor. The fuel is pumped into the float chamber. And when the correct level of the fuel is reached, then the float closes the needle valve and shuts off the petrol supply when the correct amount of petrol is available in the carburetor, then the needle valve is closed to shut off the petrol supply into the carburetor. So from the petrol tank into the carburetor, through the needle valve, the petrol enters, the fuel enters. The suction is produced by the engine. When the inlet valve is open, the air is sucked into the choke tube. Here, the air and fuel mixture are mixed. Air and fuel are mixed in this choke tube, and into the engine, this air fuel mixture is supplied. The reduced diameter of the choke tube. Here, the diameter is reduced. The reduced diameter of the choke tube increases the velocity of the air and reduces the pressure. The high velocity, low pressure in the tube facilitates the breaking up of the fuel and its mixture with the air. So here a throttle valve is there. This throttle valve controls the flow of the mixture delivered into the engine cylinder. So a carburetor, you see, carburetor has various parts. It has a float chamber, float, a lever, a needle valve. So when the correct amount of fuel is not there in the carburetor, needle valve is opened by means of lever, and the petrol from the petrol tank enters into the carburetor. And when correct amount of fuel is present in the carburetor, needle valve is closed. And during the suction stroke, in the choke tube, the fuel or the petrol is sucked or absorbed or dragged into the choke tube. At the same time, air is also dragged into the choke tube area. So here air and fuel are mixed, and this air fuel mixture enters into the engine through the inlet valve by the operation of the throttle valve. This is a simple carburetor. So whenever the fuel amount is less, this needle valve is opened again. The petrol is filled through the needle valve, and again needle valve closes. So by means of the float and float chamber lever mechanism, the petrol is filled into the carburetor. So once again, I'm going to explain. Carburetor is a device for atomizing and vaporizing the fuel and mixing with the air. It consists of a fuel jet in the choke tube area. A float chamber is provided to maintain the correct level of the fuel in the jet, and is controlled by a float and lever mechanism which operates the needle valve. The fuel is pumped into the float chamber. When the correct level of the fuel is reached, the float closes the needle valve and shuts off the petrol supply. The suction is produced by the engine. So if the suction draws the air through the choke tube, so the diameter, reduced diameter of the choke tube increases the velocity of air and reduces the pressure. The high velocity, low pressure in the tube facilitates the breaking up of the fuel and its mixture with the air. A throttle valve controls the flow of the mixture delivered into the engine cylinder. This is about the carburetor. This is a carburetor is used only in SI engine, spark ignition engine. Carburetor is used to only for supplying petrol in SI engines. Next, we have fuel pump and fuel injector in CI engines. Next, we are going to see fuel pump. Now this is fuel pump. This is not fuel injector. Fuel injector is different. Fuel pump is different. From fuel pump, the fuel is supplied to the fuel injector. From fuel injector, the fuel is sent to the cylinder head in case of CI engines. So next, draw the figure. Fuel pump. You draw the figure. Fuel pump. Okay, since time is there, why don't we see the YouTube video of working YouTube video of carburetor. We will see now initially. Okay, that is also important. We will able to know clearly how a carburetor works. Okay, we will see YouTube video of the working of a carburetor. It's better time is also there. 2-3 minutes. Wait for 2-3 minutes. We will see carburetor working. Carburetor working in YouTube. Actual working of a carburetor. So first you see how a carburetor is there generally. So this is a carburetor. Here carburetor full cleaning is on. You can see the various parts of the carburetor. This is the carburetor. You see the parts of the carburetor. First. Okay, any animation is available. Let us see animation. Animated view. This is the throttle valve. The pressure at the eventually throat depresses and becomes lower than that of the pressure atmospheric, causing the small is fed into the engine cylinder. The pressure difference between the float chamber and the throat. Petrol is entering from this portion. This is the float and float chamber. Air is entering from this portion. Air and petrol is mixing. This is the throttle valve. In this case, the idler air plate will supply sufficient fuel. Idling means, in other words, to keep the engine in a running condition when the vehicle is Okay. So in Telugu also it is available. You can see in Telugu also. So you have the excellent opportunity in YouTube. We can refer these YouTube videos also for better understanding of the various parts of the IC engine. So I think time is over. But to do the lunch and again rejoin at 1 o'clock. Thank you. Rejoin. Rejoin at 1 o'clock. 1 o'clock. What is the class next? Python. Only for 10 students are registered for Python from both sections. Still, if anybody is interested to join this Python additional course, why you are saying Python is an additional course we are offering for you, though, for the students who without backlogs and having CGPA more than 7. If you complete this Python course now, there is no necessity again for you to do the open elective in the 4-1. Okay, in 4-1 it is not necessary to do the open elective. So why only Python? Means nowadays only the jobs are in software. So to encourage you to move to software field, we are encouraging you, we are motivating you to do this course as open elective of itself. Now still now only 10 students we have given request through Google form. If anybody are interested, so they can send me by through personal WhatsApp message to me. But there is chance still now. So those who are having without backlogs and having more CGPA more than 7 are allowed till now. So if you are interested, you can send your names. Okay, we will allow you to the class. You can register for Python course. So 1-2-2 only for 10 students till now. When we have the class. Again, you can join at 2 o'clock for the period of KVM. For the period of KVM, you can join at 2 o'clock, and MP at 3 o'clock. Okay, thank you. The students without backlogs and having more than 7 CGPA, there is still chance for you to enroll for Python. Okay, good.